So welcome to the new episode of likeinnovative, and I hope now all your exams are finished, completely finished, results, waiting for results. And so today we are going to talk about satellites, exactly satellites. We know what is satellite, of course. Satellite is something in body, in orbit, and blah blah blah. Okay, let us directly start with the video. Come. Before starting a video, I want to say you a fact. Okay, so how many satellites do you think are there around Earth? 500? 600? How many? Okay, just make it correct. It is 3,700 satellites around the Earth, in which 2,600 satellites are not at all working. They are just roaming about the Earth without any reason, in orbits of course, and 1,100 are active satellites, which are really really working, efficient ones. Yes. How many satellites of them do you think is of India? It is really nice to say, because 239 satellites of the whole world, which are there around the Earth of course, are of India. See, and all of them are of course of ISRO. So let us directly start. First, we are going to talk about the highlights of 2018. Yes, highlights.
And next two, its weight is 1,425 kg. It is the type of navigation satellite and is the 8th satellite that completed the Endless constellation, or the GPS of course, and it was launched on April 12, 2018. The second one is GSLV MK3D2, big name but not of my use. Second development flight launched on 14th November 2018. It carried GS-80-29, one of the heaviest Indian satellites, to enhance broadband services in remote areas.
HYSIS. It is an hyperspectral imaging satellite, an advanced Earth observation satellite, which is also studying and will also study Earth's surface, only the surface. It can be also used for military surveillance, very important. Pulwama attack will not happen again. So after ending 2018 with 7 successful missions, in which I have only told you 3 of them, which are the best ones, the Indian Space and Research Organization, of course ISRO, has set its sight on a busy 2019 with 32 missions in the pipeline. Yeah, its moon mission is a top priority this year, of course, while the human space flight program will be further developed, with ISRO announcing it will send humanoid robots. I've said in one more video what are humanoid robots, to test Gangayaan system. Let us take a look at what it is stored for ISRO in 2019 and beyond. Yes, the first one is none other than Chandrayaan 2, India's second moon mission. Chandrayaan 2 will head the moon between January and February 2019. The GSLV MK3, which I told you earlier, an indigenously produced heavy launcher, will transport several modules into space. The orbital will circle the moon at an altitude of about 100 km and map its surface, look for SRA emissions, and measure the abundance of water on the surface. Will they find water? What do you think? Comment below. The lander will also explore the surface 600 km from the moon's south pole. It measures moon quakes and examines thermal properties of the surface. The rover will study lunar soil composition. I will make a video another for Chandrayaan 2 with a very big description in the next video which will be coming. It's India's second lunar project since Chandrayaan 1 about a decade ago, of course. And an orbiter, a lander and a revolver will be carried to the moon. Not revolver, it's rover. Sorry. It's rover. And the second one is Aditya L1. Not Aditya, it's Aditya L1. For a closer look at the sun, if you might have read the news. It is ISRO's answer to NASA. Oh, for what? Of 1.5 billion Parker solar probe, which was made by NASA, of course, and it is an answer to him. Why to fight for satellites? I don't understand. It is 800 kg satellite that will study the sun. The satellite will be placed in a halo orbit located 15 lakh kilometers from the Earth. Aditya L1 will observe solar corona with its coronagraph. The satellite will study the sun's photosphere and chromosphere, measures particle flux originating from the sun, among other analysis. Yes, I got it. Next one is Small Satellite Launch Vehicle, SSLV. An upgrade for launcher technology. Yay. It is designed to carry payloads in the 500 kg range. It's expected to transport nano and micro satellites into orbit. The first demonstration is scheduled for mid-2019. Unlike the larger Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle, PSLV, which takes 30 days to be assembled, the SSLV can be put together in 48 hours. Yeah, it means 2 days. The 30 days work will be done in 2 days. Is that possible? Of course possible. Yes. It is small than PSLV. Next one is Gangayaan, of course. And a humanoid robot will be sent. A step to putting an Indian in space. In 2019, three sets of rockets, crew and service modules for the human spacecraft program will be certified to transport humans into space. Each set will be useful for three missions, including two unmanned missions. ISRO announced the first such mission will carry a humanoid robot to conduct experiments. Of course, it's Indian. I am not gonna go until the robot is killed. To conduct experiments with human robots. Humanoid robots, not human. Manned mission likely by December 2021 or early 2022. The entire initiative is set to cost nearly 10,000 crore. The spacecraft called Gangayaan will attempt to send three Indians into the low Earth orbit for up to 7 days. Cabin temperature of it will be 23 to 22 degrees Celsius, means normal room temperature. Not like us, 35 degrees Celsius. Relative humidity inside will be 40 to 65%. And with this, I end my video and I promise to bring videos of all the satellites which I have just said now. This was just a summary. I will explain you in detail. Videos are made, editing has to be done. Okay, so with this, we end our video and don't forget to subscribe and like. And also comment some of my questions below.
down position on track for its flight to the International Space Station.